Ladies and gentlemen, one of the key participants at Starrcade 88, the Stinger. He will be ready, and he has a score to settle, no doubt, with the Road Warriors.
Wait.
Championship Wrestling, bringing you great wrestling action sanctioned by the NWA, the National Wrestling Alliance.
A lot of things are going on in the NWA, and I'm Tony Schiavone along with Jim Ross and David Crockett, and welcome to World Championship Wrestling ringside with a Major League of Professional Wrestling. Right off the bat, the World Heavyweight Champion Nature Boy Ric Flair is here, the U.S. Champion Barry Windham, Bam Bam Bigelow is here, and also here today for the first time since the split in this TV studio, the American Dream Dusty Rhodes is here, plus here today, the Legion of Doom, the Road Warriors saw at the top of the program. I know they have a lot to talk about, David.
That's right. I get to talk to the Road Warriors. Also, I'm going to talk to the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, and also a man that I really like, Rick Steiner. What about Starrcade? It's coming up.
Starrcade's coming up, and we'll have a very special Starrcade update in the next 2 hours. And plus, we're going to address the situation involving the United States Tag Team Tournament that will, of course, happen on December the 7th in Chattanooga.
And we're going to address that situation during this match. So why don't we go to the ring?
Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert and Ron Simmons, and they'll be taking on Bob Emery and Trent Knight here on World Championship Wrestling.
Tell you what, Jim Ross, you brought up a real good point about addressing the situation. Let's do it right now because these two men, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert and Ron Simmons, we're talking about the U.S. Tag Team Tournament, are now right back in the thick of things.
They certainly are, and I think we're going to hear a little bit later on.
It's coming early to Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert and Ron Simmons because the NWA Board of Directors looked at the tape where the Sheepherders took out the foreign object, hit Ron Simmons over the head, and won the match. But now it looks like Ron Simmons and Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert are going to the finals against the Fantastics for the U.S. Tag Titles on December the 7th. And Ron, I told you, I'm going to make you a champion, and what we got to do, we got to pull everything out. We got to do whatever we can to be the tag team champions.
Yeah, I agree with you, brother. But on one thing, the people pay to come to see good, wholesome, clean wrestling. And that's what we're going to give them. The Fantastic have been a longtime friends of mine and yours at this point now, right?
Yeah.
But when they get into that ring, brother, it's going to be all wrestling. Everything's going to go because we are going to go all out after those belts, brother. We want to win that tournament.
Well, there you hear from the source, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert and Ron Simmons. After meeting with the NWA Board of Directors, they made that statement, so a big break for Simmons and Gilbert. They will wrestle the Fantastics on December the 7th.
Well, it's going to be a fine confrontation between Ron Simmons, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, and the Fantastics. It's going to be a great match. There's no doubt about that. But I tell you what, we have a great program, including another Starrcade update here today on the program. We have some big announcements during that. Lex Luger's here, Sting's here. You know, and also here today, Jim, a team that we saw last week on Championship Wrestling, and certainly right at the very end, very, very impressed with these guys, the Commandos.
Combined weight, I would say somewhere in the 750 to 800 pound range, and that's not an exaggeration. And those two big men will be in the Bunkhouse Stampede at Starrcade 88 on December 26th in Norfolk, Virginia. And with men like Dr. Death Steve Williams and Dick Murdoch and Abdullah the Butcher, plus the Commandos and a host of others, about 25 men, I understand, in that. It's going to be the biggest and most dangerous bunkhouse battle royal I think that has ever been featured in the United States.
Of course, fans will have more on that information, of course, coming up during our Starrcade update, so stay right with us. Like we said, the world champion Rick Flair is here. Now let's take a look, if we would, Jim, and you can certainly know these two men quite well and are able to maybe size these up against the Fantastics, because it's going to be a fine match, even though they've never probably really wrestled each other.
I think the similarities and the parallels with Eddie Gilbert, Tommy Rogers, and Bobby Fulton are very similar, but Ron Simmons is certainly cut out of a different mold. He has less experience than the other three men I just mentioned, but he also has more strength and more power. And we would have to think right now the edge perhaps in the favor of the Fantastics simply because of the experience factor. They have been teaming together. They are considered tag team specialists, Tommy Rogers and Bobby Fulton. But I think as importantly as that right now, Tony, is it's going to be like a breath of fresh air to see a great scientific wrestling match between these four men. I really believe that's what we will see in Chattanooga on Wednesday, December 7th.
Well, you talk about the power. There's no doubt that Ron Simmons has it, the knowledge and the experience and the ability with Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert and the speed and the great teamwork with the Fantastics. Has all the ingredients to be a great championship match, and that's what it'll be, fans. On December 7th, have a great crowd here today at the studios of Superstation TBS.
Ron Simmons, who's a young Ron Simmons fan, I would think. Ron Simmons has got fans all over the country. Young fans that have heard his message of say no to drugs. Tag made Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert. We made the comment that Gilbert, one of the most technically sound athletes in the sport today, and he has got to have helped Ron Simmons in his progress. I think Gilbert has accelerated Ron Simmons' progress, Tony, in the last few weeks especially.
Well, there's no doubt that Eddie Gilbert has a wealth of experience and knowledge about the sport, and being able to take that wealth and experience is another talent altogether.
I want to say a special hello to the fans tonight in Greensboro. Tonight at 8 o'clock. Great card at the Greensboro Coliseum. Starts at 8 o'clock tonight. And, of course, tomorrow night in my friend Tony Schiavone's home state in Richmond, Virginia. Great card tomorrow night at the Richmond Coliseum. And that event, Tony, starts at 7:30 for all the fans in Richmond.
Got a great week ahead of us, too. And, of course, we'll be talking about that during the course of this program, especially our fans right south of us in Macon, Georgia.
Gilbert working on the arm of Trent Knight. I'll tell you what, they really got robbed in their semifinal match, and it was great to see that the NWA board has made a stand and made a decisive decision regarding the breaking of the rules and using foreign objects, disqualifications, and so forth, because Simmons and Gilbert really deserved to be in the finals. They didn't deserve to lose the way that it happened. They didn't really, the minds of their fans, didn't really lose that match. It was stolen from them.
Well, I tell you, if you go back now, the NWA has been making, Jim, some very decisive decisions, very firm decisions, considering. Mr. Jim Crockett came out here and said whoever wins between Dusty Rhodes and Road Warrior Animal would claim the world's six-man belt. That is a decision that we've never seen before. That's a first in the NWA. And now we have this reversal of the decision. I think the NWA is looking at some of the things happening and doing things that are in the best interest of the fans. Not that they haven't in the past, but even more so now.
And, of course, that match with Rhodes and Road Warrior Animal will take place also on Wednesday, December the 7th in Chattanooga, Tennessee. High elevation, Bob Emery up in the lights, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, but there's Ron Simmons, and he comes off with great velocity, extends his legs. He was number 50 for the Florida State Seminoles, and with Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert on December the 7th, he has the opportunity to win his very first major wrestling championship, the U.S. Tag Titles. Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert and Ron Simmons will battle the Fantastics on Wednesday, December 7th. Look at the way he extends his legs. Great velocity. He's a great athlete.
All right, there are your winners on our first event here on World Championship Wrestling. And back with more right after this timeout. Nikita Koloff, Terry Jones in this event on World Championship Wrestling. Nikita Koloff in the ring, and Ivan Koloff, Jim, has joined you at ringside.
You certainly have. Ivan, I know you've got a lot on your mind surrounding Paul Jones.
That is right. I'm sure Paul Jones and the Assassins realize now that he's gotten himself in more trouble than he would like. because he is reluctant in signing chain match. He's reluctant in signing any type of match against W. Nikita and myself. He made a mistake by jumping on me, beating me up, double-crossing me for his own selfish gain. And you see now, Paul Jones, you see Nikita in ring. He is, even though I've lost 20 pounds, he has still kept his strength in the ring, and he's got that dynamic power when it comes to competition in any type of situation. You see, nephew Nikita, I have been very proud of him for many years. He has proven, like I have proven over the years, that we are master of the chain. In chain matches against any opponent by defeating numerous opponents in time past. But now, Paul Jones, what are you going to do next? Are you going to run and hide, continuously hiding, putting your assassins on the shelf and you hiding in the hole? Well, you cannot keep putting up with this. Because you see, Paul Jones, I know you're a man with a lot of pride yourself. And you're going to have to come out of hiding. You're going to have to muster your assassins up to getting the courage to come back in the ring and sign some type of match against us. And I'm looking forward to this day, Paul Jones. Nikita's also looking forward to it. You see, Nikita, he never lets up on his opponents. He never gives them any mercy. He's got that speed in the ring, and he still's got the power. And he is not going to let up when it comes to your assassins. He made me a promise, nephew Nikita. He said, Uncle Ivan, he said, I don't care what it takes, how long it takes, or what type of situation I have to get in against these assassins. You just take care of this Paul Jones, if the little weasel doesn't stick his nose in it, and I'll take care of the assassins. But I said, nephew Nikita, let me just have my hands on them one time also, because after the way they beat me down, I want to get in there also.
Ivan, I know you've got a lot of respect for the Russians' athletic ability. Oh, well, there's the Russian sickle. That's your hold, Ivan.
That's what I taught Nikita over the years, and there is no one that can apply the sickle like nephew Nikita.
Ivan, thank you very much, and best of luck to you. Ladies and gentlemen, the Koloffs indeed have a date with destiny and the Russian assassins, and this may be what will be wedding the masked man and Paul Jones, the Russian sickle. We talked a lot about Starrcade, December 26th. Now let's go to Tony Schiavone with a special Starrcade update. It's time for our Starrcade update. As you know, it's coming up the day after Christmas on Monday, December 26th at the Norfolk Scope Coliseum in Norfolk, Virginia. It's the big event, Starrcade 88 True Grit. We have some big announcements about Starrcade to tell you here today. First of all, the very first Bunkhouse Stampede will be held during Starrcade with such stars as Dr. Death, Steve Williams, Abdullah the Butcher, Dick Murdoch. We're talking about over 25 of the NWA's top stars. Come as you are, anything goes in the ring, over the top rope, Bunkhouse Battle Royal. And the last man standing in the ring will be considered the winner. Also, to be held during Starrcade, it's the Battle of the Midnight Expresses, the original Midnight Express with Paulie Dangerously to battle Jim Cornette's Midnight Express in what will be, no doubt, an all-out war between two fine tag teams in the NWA. Also, another great tag team match has been signed. Ivan and Nikita Koloff against Russian Assassin 1 and 2 with Paul Jones. But a special stipulation, as a matter of fact, two special stipulations. If the Russian Assassins lose in this match, they will have to unmask. In addition, if the Russian Assassins lose, Paul Jones must retire from professional wrestling. That is another stipulation. Now let's tell you about a big match still in the works. As you know, Rick Steiner and Mike Rotunda. The split has occurred in the varsity club ranks. Well, on the table right now, still under negotiation, hopefully to be signed next week, Mike Rotunda to defend the World Television title against Rick Steiner. What a great match that will be. But also, here's a match which has been signed. It's the match of matches, the colossal event. Ric Flair, the World Heavyweight Champion, against the Total Package Lex Luger. I do understand from the offices of the NWA that next week, right here on our Starrcade update, we will have an announcement on a very special stipulation concerning Nature Boy Ric Flair and Lex Luger, the rematch for the NWA World Heavyweight title. That'll be covered up next week. So until then, we'll see you right here on the Starrcade update. going to be Lex Luger and Sting taking on Bryan Adams and Jerry Price. And you've got to think right now, Tony, that the Stinger is sky high after the announcement that we heard you make just a few moments ago regarding Starrcade 88, December 26th in Norfolk. There's no doubt about it. We will have a special stipulation next week concerning Ric Flair, Lex Luger for the World Heavyweight title. And it's going to be, I understand, although not knowing what the stipulation is right now, a very, very major announcement, one of the biggest by the NWA. The fans watch out here at Superstation TBS. Luger, obviously in tremendous physical condition. Here comes the Stinger. And, of course, to say he hasn't even scratched the surface.
I've got some real technical wrestling now.
He's biting technical wrestling. He's biting Jerry Price. We know that Sting wants to get it on with the Road Warriors in any shape, form, or fashion. That situation is certainly not subsided whatsoever. As a matter of fact, it's increased in intensity in recent weeks.
Well, there are a lot of things going on in the NWA, and one of the things, certainly the big thing right now we're thinking about is Starrcade and Lex Luger and Ric Flair. If we go back now, Jim, and think about back on the 10th of July, that was the match that certainly was one of the greatest matches I have ever seen. But still, you kind of left with an empty feeling, because when the bell sounded, if we go back in our mind and think about that, when the bell sounded, we all thought that we had a new World Heavyweight Champion.
Tony, if there was such a thing as points in professional wrestling, I think we could say that Luger was ahead on points at the time the match was stopped by the Maryland State Athletic Commission.
Well, Luger certainly was in command at the time the match ended. And I guess of the thousands upon thousands of fans watching in Baltimore and across the country that night, I guess the most shocked of anyone was Lex Luger. I mean, there was a celebration going on in the ring at that time when the announcement was made.
Well, the NWA board has been very busy. We know they did the action, reviewed the tape, involved with Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert and Ron Simmons going to the finals. As Sting bites the arm of Jerry Price.
And I'll tell you what, you know, it's, and to give a lot of credit to the NWA, it is not easy negotiating with Ric Flair, James J. Dillon, and the Four Horsemen Corporation, so to speak. That is a very difficult process, we know. We found out right after the Great American Bash how difficult it was. So it's credit to them that they got it together one more time.
Luger and Sting completely outclassing these opponents. But their emotion right now has just got to be phenomenal. David's going to be talking with them. Vertical suplex. Remember, he's 6'5", 275 pounds. Luger played professional football in the National Football League, played the CFL, of course, in Canada. Was recruited out of high school by Joe Paterno and signed with Penn State and transferred to play for Coach Lou Saban for the Miami Hurricane, longtime pro coach. So Luger's got a very storied background as far as athletic accomplishments are concerned.
Tell you what, if you take a look, and Sting, of course, still waiting on a big announcement concerning possibly his involvement in Starrcade. And I know, like you said, the Road Warriors, but going back to the Luger situation as he looks for a tag right now, watch Sting. Coming down with a splash again. Take a look at Luger now, Jim Ross, and compare that to the Lex Luger we saw in July. There's been a lot of improvement, even though he was that close, so to speak, to the World Heavyweight Championship.
The improvement has not been in his physique because it's perfect. The improvement has been in his attitude and his thought process. And I really think now, more than ever, he feels like he can beat Ric Flair for the World Heavyweight Championship. And, of course, we'll be talking a great deal about that between now and December 26th. There's the Stinger splash. And Bryan Adams, I thought he was a rock singer from Canada. Guess not. And the package tagged in, signaling that it's time for the human torture rack. This is a position that I remember most vividly from July the 10th in the sold-out Baltimore Arena when world champion Ric Flair was up there. The bell sounded and the place erupted because they thought that we had a new heavyweight champion of the world.
Well, he'll get his chance. These two men, Luger and Sting, quite a combination also. They were the winners of the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup, and it's been a great year for both these men. If you go back in January all the way until right now, it's been a fine year. But still to come, the big event for both of them, Starrcade. Okay, right now, after the Stinger Splash, here's the tag, and Jim, here comes Lex Luger.
Luger comes in with his signature maneuver. This is a move that people are saying will beat Ric Flair for the world's title. You get up there, there's no way down. Ric Flair or any other athlete, this is too much for any human to handle. And this is what he wants. December 26th is his day. Can he make it happen?
Well, he's got to get him in that backbreaker to beat him. Now let's go to David Crockett at ringside.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, before Starrcade, usually people are uptight, but these two guys, they're having a good time, a real good time. These fans are
tight. Uptight, I think it's looking pretty tight, if you know what I'm talking about. You know what, these Road Warriors, these dudes are messing with me. These dudes tried to break my neck.
Right.
Yeah, they tried to break my neck, but you know why you didn't? You know why you didn't, Animal? You know why you didn't, Hawk? Because I'm me. That's why. You know what you guys are doing? You know what they're doing to people like you? Lex Luger, me, and Dusty Rhodes, and especially everybody out there. You know what they're doing? I can't say what they're doing, but that's what they're doing to all the people. I don't do that to the people, and the Total Package doesn't either, and neither does Dusty Rhodes. Woo! Greensboro's tonight. And oh, I'm just getting that view over there in the camera of tightness. And look at tight right there, too.
Oh, woo! That's right.
You know, David Crockett, tonight, Greensboro, North Carolina. You know, Road Warriors, we've had a few matches now, me and Sting with you, and you know what? You know what happened? You didn't kick our butts. Look, you tell me you're gonna. A matter of fact, we've gotten the upper hand. And in Greensboro, North Carolina, the hotbed of NWA professional wrestling for many years, they're gonna see firsthand what the Stinger and the Total Package can do as a tag team. And that's wreak havoc in the world of professional wrestling, and especially with the big, bad Road Warriors. Another thing, David, I know you want to speak to me about one other thing.
Right.
It's a major, major announcement. I'm always there for Stinger. Stinger's always there for me. We never stand in each other's way.
And you know I am.
And Starrcade is the biggest show every year in the sport of professional wrestling. And I have gotten a match with a man who's come out here for 2 months, has ignored who's been rated as the number one to contend in our sport, and that's the Total Package, Lex Luger, to that world heavyweight title. Nature Boy, the NWA has mandated it. The match is gonna happen in Starrcade. There's a special stipulation. I already know what it is, but a few details need to be worked out, but I can guarantee everybody out there, there will be a winner between Ric Flair and myself in Starrcade 88 True Grit. Look at that Stinger, baby. Let's give it one more pose. Yeah!
All right, ladies and gentlemen, Starrcade, the day after Christmas. More action to come right after this.
Well, a hush falls over the crowd as the Commandos make their way to the ring.
We're talking 800 pounds here. I asked that the long-haired guy right there, Mr. Boone, Commando Boone.
Commando Boone?
Yeah. How much he weighed? I asked him from a distance. He weighs 444.
Oh, my goodness.
This is an 800-pound team. This is the biggest team in wrestling, and this team, fans, will be in the Buckhouse Stampede Battle Royals with about 25 other guys.
The thing I want to see is someone throw this guy over the top rope.
Yeah.
It'll take more than one.
It'll take a winch, a tow truck.
But, you know, you say he's 444. You take a look at the other half of the Commandos, you got to be pushing 850 here.
I bet people that, you know, a buffet owner would just cringe to see these guys pull up in front of his restaurant, wouldn't
they? I'll tell you what, you never know what these guys got up their sleeve. They are certainly,
ooh,
and vastly, but becoming an awesome force in the sport, and we saw him last week during championship wrestling. We're very impressed, and we're taking a look at him now on our two-hour program, and Randy Mulkey gets guillotined.
444 pounds.
Oh, gosh!
Right outside on his back. Hey, 3-4s will beat most hands, I'll tell you that right now. 3-4 is better than two of a kind.
Well,
hey, come on, Commander.
Randy stuck on there like he had Velcro hooked on him. Now he peels him off, brings him into the ring.
You know, when you put like Abdul the Butcher in one of these battle royals, a veteran like Dick Murdoch that's been in a million battle royal, in the ring and out of the ring. Dr. Destiny Williams, get 25 or 30 guys in this thing for some big bucks, $25,000, $30,000, $40,000, $50,000. You know, at Starrcade 88, $50,000. Come dressed as you are. There will be no disqualifications in that battle royal, obviously. That's where you separate the men from the boys, and these are will be the biggest two men in the event.
I think it's safe to say that these two men certainly are made for a bunkhouse stampede. There's no doubt about it. Watch out here. Just laid out any sweat. No finesse about these men, Jim. You know exactly what they're going to do.
Come right at you, straight ahead. You're not going to see me do any cute little wrestling moves. They don't come to the ring with any fancy music. They want to beat people up in any way that they can. And Eddie Sweat there probably wishes he would have gone to dental school or something besides what he's doing here for a living here on Superstation TBS on this day.
I tell you what, they are big, but you know, they have been really going at this team, at these opponents, Sweat and Mulkey, hot and heavy. They have not let up, showing a lot of endurance for big men, just staying right with them, not letting up at all. Randy Mulkey might as well be hitting the wall here in the studio somewhere.
Big, rough man. There he is again. You gotta come down when you go up there. Tag made.
Each blow, you know, you talk about the high impact maneuvers. Each move is the ultra high impact maneuver. Every slam, every power slam is just like they're putting him through the mat.
Commando Ray there, he's a little one. He's only 400. His partner, 444. He must have went to the farmer's co-op and jumped on the feed scales.
Watch out.
We might want to notify Mulkey's next to Ken here.
Oh, here we go.
Lord have mercy. A double splash. He was completely engulfed in humanity. Mulkey surrounded by camouflage, 800 pounds. And they want the big bread. They'll be at Starrcade 88 Monday, December 26th. They're going to go for $50,000. You know, I thought Abdul the Butcher at 400 was a monster. Look at these two guys, and they are going to be together.
Well, we all say sometimes it hurts looking at it, and it really hurts watching this again. Your winners, the Commandos, the one and only world champion, is with David Crocker.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, you've heard the news. Starrcade, Ric Flair, Lex Luger, but understand there's some special stipulations, Rick, isn't that correct?
Well, you know, I've sat here on this television program in front of millions of fans going on 10 years now. That's how long Ric Flair has been associated with Turner Broadcasting. And right now, the National Wrestling Alliance, as it does every year, is going to put together the greatest spectacular in sports. Not just wrestling, but in my estimation, the greatest spectacular in sports. Because as the wrestling world knows, and as the real smart sports fans know, the wrestlers, the big name wrestlers today, make more money than any other athletes in any other sport. And right now, Jim Crockett Promotions, Turner Broadcasting, one more time. They've had James Dillon right there in the lawyer's office. They said, J.J., Flair's got to do this or the pressure's going to be on. And Jim Dillon, representing me, representing the Four Horsemen, the bottom line, representing the World Heavyweight Championship, signed the contract. Then we hear, by the way, Mr. Dillon, there's going to be a special stipulation. We'll tell you and Flair about it next week. Well, let me explain something to you. You see, the bottom line is, and I'm going to do this for all the sports fans out there, that don't really have a grasp of what's going on. You talk about two great athletes, and as I've said before, Luger, God bless you, you got more athletic ability and more athletic skills than any man I've ever competed against. But once again, I'm going to give you your due by telling you that to be the man, regardless of all of those God-given gifts, you've got to beat the man. And the World Heavyweight Championship is the trophy. I don't care what you read about, what you hear about, what someone tries to tell you is taking place on a make-believe basis. That championship belt costs $40,000. It's the real McCoy. And I don't care if it's Mike Tyson or Sugar Ray Leonard. They both ask me for my autograph, and they both go, "Hey, champ, how are you?" You know, and that's a feeling that very few men in the world of professional sports know anything about. To be the world champion, number one, whether you like them or you don't like them, the bottom line is, ladies and gentlemen, it doesn't get any better than this.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, Ric Flair, Lex Luger, Starrcade rematch. Watch for it. With us now, the United States Heavyweight Champion, Barry Windham and J.J. Dillon. J.J. handling the negotiations for the World Heavyweight Champion, Ric Flair. But there's a man, Bam Bam Bigelow, that would like to get hold of Barry Windham.
Well, I've had a real problem, as Mr. Flair has already indicated. Negotiations have been hot and heavy in the office of the NWA. I'm in there, I've got lawyers on all sides chomping in my ear, trying to get all this fine print worked out, and really trying to nail the World Heavyweight Champion to the wall. And every time I go out to use a phone to confer with my lawyers, that sleazy Sir Oliver Humperdinck is in there trying to pull some shenanigans of his own. And as we already saw this morning, Humperdinck has now got Bam Bam Bigelow all revved up, and he's waiting till Barry Windham has matches on TV, main event matches, where he has to put out 100% effort. And then the minute that he sees one little open, we get typical Humperdinck activity, which is backstabbing, back jumping.
Let me tell you what, Bam Bam Bigelow will not face me face to face. He always has to come in, like James said, when I'm in a main event match, when I am at my utmost, and I am when I am working hard. Let me tell you what, Bam Bam Bigelow, the championship is right here. All you have to do is sign for the match, and if you have the guts, face me face to face, and we'll go to it the way men should.
Now, I'm gonna admit that he did catch Barry Windham with that splash, and if he comes off with 396 pounds, there is that possibility that he could secure a three count. But Mr. Humperdinck, you better tell Mr. Bigelow that the next time he gets in the air and comes down on Barry Windham, it's going to be a different story, because they're going to start one-on-one, starting fresh across the ring, and you got to get this great athlete down before you can jump on him, and I'm not so sure you can do that.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're talking about the beast from the east, Bam Bam Bigelow. Let's go to the ring and see him in action. Here on World Championship Wrestling. Tell you what, to defeat a Barry Windham or even a Nature Boy Ric Flair in a title match is a very difficult thing to do. You know, always the champion has the odds with him, because I guess that's the way the match is designed. It's the way it happens in professional wrestling. You, as a champion, a time limit draw, you'll keep the title. Disqualification, you'll keep the title. And, of course, if you're a member of the Four Horsemen, you got a lot of friends around you to help you keep the title. So, as great an athlete as Bam Bam Bigelow is and as Lex Luger is, these two men certainly have the odds against them to dethrone the champion. I don't think anybody denies that, Jim.
Great snap suplex by Bam Bam Bigelow, a man with uncanny agility. 4 pounds shy of that 400-pound mark. And when we talk about the Buckhouse Stampede, we talk about come dressed as you are, anything goes, that tattooed head will be in many of the Buckhouse Stampedes, and the one I'm specifically referring to will be on Monday, December 26th in Norfolk, Virginia at the Scope. The Commandos at over 800 combined. Bigelow in there. Abdullah the Butcher at 400. Dr. Death at 295. Dick Murdoch, he's close to 300-pound mark, depending on how many long necks, how much barbecue he had the night before. And I'll tell you something, Murdoch is just as apt to win that thing as anybody else.
That's right.
Because he knows what it's like to get into a crowd and defend himself. But 25 guys in there, we've always been told that the Battle Royal was the most dangerous match in wrestling because you had people all around you. You were in a completely different environment than a wrestler is under normal circumstances. When he put $50,000 on the line, and you got I'd like to add up the entries, and maybe next week we can do that, and how much pounds will be in the ring? We're talking several tons of humanity in the ring on December 26th for $50,000. Standing drop kick. A lot of junior heavyweights can't execute that move right there.
And it was executed to perfection that time. You mentioned about the bunkhouse stampede. And, you know, Jim, you were talking about Dick Murdoch. And a lot of times, and we've seen many bunkhouse stampedes in our years, and this is the fourth year of it. As you see, our Starcade, one of our camera ladies with the Starcade television, our Starcade T-shirt on.
She's working television?
Television.
What's him coming? Bigelow, reverse chin lock. Look at the tattoos in this guy. Man, I'll tell you. I just can't. You know, I asked him how long it took him to get his head tattooed. 1 year.
1 year?
1 year.
You mean he went back? He kept going back to do it?
Every other month for 1 year, he sat in the tattoo parlor for 3 or 4 hours with those needles in his head. Hey, that's...
I guess once you started, you had to go all the way because just part of it wouldn't look good at all.
Oh, no. No, a part of a tattoo. I've always said that part of a tattoo's... But, you know, I'll tell you something, Tony. This guy, he's also a man that is looking for his first major championship. And if... You know, JJ's so involved right now with the NWA and the board on these stipulations with this championship match. I think JJ's very antsy. The look I got on his face, he looked to me like he was a little apprehensive about his meetings. I'm sure he got the money from the NWA for the Flair-Luger match, but I don't know. The stipulation thing seems to have him troubled somewhat. And right here, this is going to trouble Keith Steinbrenner a great deal, I can assure you.
Well, there's your face first suplex. There are many people that says that the empire is crumbling, and I say, in response to that, what I've always said and what has always rung true, and that is when you think you got the four horsemen on the retreat, they're going to stop short and hit you right in the mouth.
Major day, the World Series of Wrestling. Day after Christmas, David Crockett will be there, and he will also be at ringside with Bam Bam Bigelow and Sir Oliver Humperdinck.
Sir Oliver Humperdinck, Barry Windham and J.J. Dillon said that the only way Bam Bam is going to win is to attack Barry Windham from behind.
The only way Bam Bam Bigelow is going to force Barry Windham into a match with him is if he humiliates him. You know, I had an opportunity to hear Dillon out here flipping off again. Boy, this guy, he thinks he's got me pegged, right? He knows me for a long time, and he knows that I'll do anything it takes to get what I want. I've never said I was a choir boy. I know every dirty trick there is to know. In fact, I wrote the book. And Barry Windham, I know how to force people like you into wrestling matches, and that's get right into your face and embarrass you at every turn possible. Now, there's something that we desire. We desire that U.S. title, and Barry Windham, sooner or later, through hook or through crook, you're going to have to put your name on that dotted line. And James J. Dillon, the administrator, he's used to dealing with contracts. Well, the contract is in your court. We have signed it, we have sealed it, and we've delivered it to his office. And if he's half a man, if he's even half a man, you're going to put your name on the line, Barry Windham, because this man right here, the man of flame and fire, is coming after that U.S. title, and I want to get it so bad I can taste it. Bam Bam, what do you think? U.S. title?
U.S. title. Everybody knows that the NWA has the most prestigious wrestling titles in the professional wrestling today. And the U.S. Heavyweight Championship is going to be mine. Windham, your history.
And if it takes me finagling outside that ring, J.J. Dillon, you think you're dangerous? Well, you ain't seen nothing yet because I'm the baddest of them all.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, listen, coming up next, you're going to see the original Midnight Express. With us now, Paul E. Dangerously of the original Midnight Express.
You know, at Starrcade, it's finally going to be proven by us that we are the one and the only team truly deserving of the name. Ladies and gentlemen, the lethal weapon Loverboy Dennis, the messenger of mayhem ravishing Randy, the one and the only Midnight Express!
Much fire and venom. I mean, he nailed Jim Cornette with a telephone, and Cornette was seriously injured, we thought, at that time. And, well, I don't know about Paul E. Dangerously, but I do know about his two men. But, you know, we said the same thing about Jim Cornette when we first saw Jim Cornette here on the Superstation a couple of years back. We didn't know about Jim Cornette, but we found out that he really was very effective as a manager. He had a very good tag team, and I think it's going to be proven also with Randy and Dennis.
They're going to prove it on December the 26th for sure. Starrcade 88. You know, we want to tell the fans that we have great action coming up. Of course, tomorrow night in Richmond. That event starts at 7:30 at the Richmond Coliseum tomorrow night. We're also going to be just south of here down in Macon. And then the NWA will get on the plane and they'll head to Las Vegas for this Tuesday night. San Francisco this Wednesday night. Dangerous, he may be calling somebody in Albuquerque. That's where the NWA will be on Thursday. And that's just the start of a big weekend next weekend for the NWA, Tony.
Next weekend, of course, we go to Texas. Amarillo on Friday, Houston Saturday, and Lubbock on Sunday. That's going to be a big weekend in the Lone Star State.
Fans are really excited about that out in Texas. Thanks to the folks of Church's Fried Chicken for their support. Ravishing Randy, that's a powerful slam. These guys are, you know, if we discount Dangerously's mouth, ponytail or not, and that's the right part of a horse's anatomy as far as I'm concerned for him, but they are a great team. This team, as you said, Tony, so pointed out that weeks ago they made the debut ever for anybody in the NWA. These guys, people are still talking about that unprovoked attack on Jim Cornette. And Cornette hasn't forgotten it because I haven't seen Cornette without carrying that blood-stained jacket, the reminder of what happened to him right here in this very studio.
Well, it's something that is not going to go unanswered. You can be sure of that. But in the ring, Loverboy Dennis and Ravishing Randy make a fine tag team. And that gets back to the point of the name, the Midnight Express. They claim they are the original Midnight Express. And, you know, realistically, you think, well, what's in a name? You know, is it that big of a deal? Well, for a solid 4 years here, Beautiful Bobby and Jim Cornette were the cornerstone of the Midnight Express. Sweet Stan came along. They went to their greatest record ever. And it means a lot to these guys and to the fans also. Right now, let's go to David Crockett.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, in our next hour, you're going to see the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. Also, the Road Warriors. We're going to be talking to Rick Steiner and much more right after the scoreboard. All right, ladies and gentlemen, signed, sealed, and we're going to deliver to you the day after Christmas at Starrcade, the Midnight Express against the original Midnight Express.
It's finally going to happen, huh? You guys are coming out here, and you're screaming, we're a bunch of back jumpers, huh? So now you want to meet us face-to-face in front of the whole world on Starrcade, huh? Jim Cornette, I've told you to your face before that when you were a kid, every time, every day after school, you went around the state of Kentucky and you went up to every single truck driver saying, are you my father? Huh? That's not the kind of guy that I think can lead a tag team to defeat the real Midnight Express. You see, Bobby Eaton,
You're coming out here and you're sitting here and you're letting all that anger just bottle up. And you want it to come out at Starrcade, huh? Jim Cornette doesn't like you, Bobby. If he did, he wouldn't be telling you to go against Dennis and Randy. He'd invest in money for a speech therapist for you. As for you, Stan Lane, you better go and get a job at Chippendales, because you got a lot better future doing that than you do trying to prove yourself to the real Midnight Express. No, we're not going to be the gangsters of love. And no, we're not going to be the salt in a swing. This man is now called the lethal weapon. And this is the messenger of mayhem. And at the end of Starrcade, after they beat up Bobby, after they humiliate Stan and show that they are the real Midnight Express, not just the original, then, Mr. Cornette, Dennis is going to take you by one arm, and Randy's going to take you by the other. And Dennis is going to take that lethal weapon and knock your teeth down your throat. And then Randy's going to take that size 12 boot of his and knock him right back out through your mouth. And then I, my friend, am going to hold you up to the camera. And I'm going to make you, with no teeth, looking like Leon Spinks, talking like this, look in that camera and say, yes, Paulie, dangerously. Dennis and Randy are not only the original, but they are the only Midnight Express. You can bank at it at Starrcade.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that's going to take place at Starrcade the day after Christmas. Oh, yeah. Now let's go to the ring in the Varsity Club. These two men have created a fine tag team. We have signs, banners here in the studio, and people cheering for Rick Steiner. You hear what they say, we want Steiner. They're emphatic about it. That's all over the country. I'll tell you something. I get a kick out of the Steiner comes to the ring in any building, and the crowd starts barking. Sound like a big dog pound, Steiner's dog pound or something. Dr. Death making Mike Jackson into a human-like pretzel. Back into the corner, tag made. This potentially one of the finest tag teams ever in the NWA. In my opinion, Williams and Rotunda. Sullivan adds that very dangerous element also, Tony, outside the ring. And he's a bizarre man.
Well, we can't deny the fact that Kevin Sullivan was a great athlete himself. And certainly has teamed with his men on many occasions, whether it be with Rotunda or in a six-man.
We talk about the amateur background of Williams and Rotunda, their leader, the coach out there, a four-time state high school wrestling champion at four different weights. He was in high school just outside Boston. So he knows what it's like to train these guys, get them pumped up. They're not going to make a lot of mistakes, these two guys. They've called timeout. There's no timeouts, fellas.
Well, when you're the Varsity Club and you're going up in a match like this where certainly your talent really overshadows your opponents, you can do anything you want, it would appear. It would not be advisable for the young man to come in, Mr. Anderson, to come in and in that corner try to break up that meeting.
No, I don't think I'd want to get involved in that whatsoever. Dr. Death, Steve Williams impatiently waiting on the outside. Rotunda, his big date with Destiny. Coming up, I'm sure he'll be involved in Starrcade, quite obviously.
Well, we mentioned during, Jim, during the update that Rick Steiner and Mike Rotunda, that contract has been presented. Now both sides have to agree on possible stipulations or winner's purse or whatever. There's a lot of things that go into contract negotiations. And certainly, I know as far as Steiner is concerned, I'm sure he's not worrying about any monetary award or any stipulation. He just wants to get in the ring with him.
Dr. Death with a slam there. Well, I tell you what, these guys are unbelievable. We certainly hope that all the fans had a great Thanksgiving. We appreciate all the fans being with us in the Omni. Thanksgiving night. As a young man, Rick Steiner.
Look at that.
Nice artwork.
Meanwhile, in the ring, Doc is doing some nice artwork on his opponent here.
I think if Dr. Death and Rotunda want to have a business, they could call it Bruises R Us, because they have hammered this guy.
There's an old Rick Steiner move right there that Steiner has used. As the fans watch on here, I tell you, Steiner and Rotunda, I think here's a team. I know the Road Warriors have the World Tag Team title and the situation with the U.S. title still up in the air, but here's a team. You give them a couple of more weeks together, because they haven't teamed together that often. You're going to be seeing big things from them as a team.
And there's their leader. Here's their inspirational leader, the Charles Manson-like Kevin Sullivan. He's got all the Psycho movies on tape. He watches them for motivation.
Well, I'm sure he does. Watch out, clothesline, Sullivan on the floor. There is what Steiner has to watch out for. If he has a match, let's say, with Mike Rotunda or with a Dr. Death, there are two other men around. We've belabored the point over and over, I know, but it probably rings true more with Kevin Sullivan and his men than with anyone else. Sullivan probably gets physically involved more than any manager that we have seen.
They really hurt people. It's almost like their team was underwritten by the National Chiropractors Association, because they do batter some people. They are high impact. They can wrestle you. They can fight you. Steiner has got a tall, tall order in his quest to get even with the varsity club. Can one man do it? There's three of them. This guy is just, he's out on his feet. I think he's been beat a long time. Doc with a clothesline. I haven't seen this guy here before, Doc. I don't know if we'll see him again. Tony?
I don't think so. Doc has him by the trunk, said, here comes your butterfly suplex over the top. And the man was out, to say the least.
Well, I'm sure his next of kin will be happy to see that it's finally all over for him. Williams and Rotunda are bad. And Steiner has, I tell you what, I don't envy Rick Steiner's position right now.
Here they are, the Varsity Club with Kevin Sullivan.
You know, it's real simple. It's real simple. Hey, call him. Yeah, call Steiner on here. You know why? It's real simple. I traded a moron. I traded an Edsel for Rolls Royce. It's real simple. Here is the greatest world TV champion of all time. Here is the greatest athlete come out of the University of Oklahoma. Sure, we got rid of Rick Steiner. You're calling for Rick Steiner. The last time I saw Rick Steiner, the Dark had stripped him, and Mike had put the boots to him, and I kicked in his brains. In. So, come on, Steiner. So now he's got his own little friend to play with.
He was nuts.
Oh, my God.
Is the guy nuts or what?
Totally nuts, Mike.
This guy, Kevin, is a partner. He's somebody I can count on. Tell him, Doc. Is it?
You know something, Mike and Kevin?
What, Mike?
I heard from a little birdie. Loose lips sink ships. And this ship ain't going down. This is a team that's combined with three athletes that has totally control over the matches. And as Kevin and Mike know, we're like machinery. We run on fuel. And it's like the Road Warriors say, a snack on danger. Well, let me say something to the Road Warriors and everybody. You have to come through us to find out how tough you really are.
It's real simple, Doc. Starrcade is built for this. Starrcade is the biggest event that people wait for all year round. Steiner, you want him? You got him. And you got all of us together. You don't have a snowball's chance at Haiti.
As you can see, ladies and gentlemen, that everybody's getting ready for Starrcade. More action to come. Rick Steiner's going to be here. The American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, the Road Warriors, and much more. All right, ladies and gentlemen, here they are, the World Tag Team Champions, the mighty Road Warriors, Hawk and Animal.
David Crockett, I'd like to just say one thing. We like to say to everybody out there, thanks for all the hate mail you've been sending us. It's quite an inspiration to us. Matter of fact, it inspires us to hurt, maim, and disrupt lives more than we already have. Now let's give some credit due where credit's due. Lex Luger and Sting, we never underestimated you as physical specimens. We just underestimated what you had between your ears to back it up. So we found out that you're not any stronger or bigger than we thought. You're just a little bit smarter than we thought. Our mistake, but when we make mistakes, we always compromise by doing something about it. And what we're gonna do about it is in Greensboro tonight, we're gonna rip some stinking face. And it ain't gonna be ours, it's gonna be yours. Yeah! And there's one thing that will always remain different between the two of you and the two of us. We simply don't care. You know, the other night in the ring, I heard Animal hit Sting, and he made a sound like it hurts. Well, you ain't heard any sounds come out of us like that. Because if it did hurt, and sometimes it does, we gonna let you know about it. The other thing different between you and us is we got these and you don't. Tell them, Animal.
Yo, Dave Crockett, I heard I got a match December 7th against Dusty Rhodes, right?
That's correct.
Dusty Rhodes, you seem to forget we ain't doing this sport. Just like you had, your credentials speak for themselves. You got a long history of wins against great opponents. But we made a name for ourselves by beating legends. Legends just like you. So you're going to find out what I'm all made of December 7th, and you ain't going to like it one bit.
Oh. All right, Paul. He's just walking away without saying a word. Paul Ellery, the World Tag Team Champions. They leave us. We don't know what, you know, he heard Animal talk about the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. That match is going to take place December 7th. Talk about the American Dream. Here he comes. Hey, Dusty, he was out here just talking about
it. Let me tell you something about this old Texas boy right here. You've been coming out here week in and week out talking trash. Let's don't wait till Chattanooga, Tennessee, Daddy. Let's don't wait till December the 7th. If you want some of the dream, the legend, if you will, in public, come on out and get it right now.
All right, Dusty wants him. Dusty said, Animal, if you want him, get in the ring. Here comes Animal. Why'd you want him so bad? You want him, go get him. All right, it's going to break down right here. They're not going to wait till December the 7th in Chattanooga. Big Road Warrior Animal, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. This is like a street fight here. He misses with a clothesline. Rhodes to the far side, catches Animal with a clothesline. And he's trying to choke. Well, that's 2-on-1, Tony.
Well, you knew it would happen, Jim Ross. You knew good and well with all the Road Warriors here that it would be more. And all of a sudden, we see Animal. He has taken off one of the spikes. He has taken off a spike, and he has hit Dusty in the head with it.
He just hit Rhodes right in the face.
Oh, my goodness.
God, he's put it in his eye. He's put the spike in his eye.
He is jabbing him in the eye, or has with the spike. He unhooked it from his shoulder pads or whatever it was, and he's jabbing in Dusty's eye. He's opened Dusty up.
Oh, my God. They're trying to put his eye out.
This is horrible.
They're sticking that spike right in his eye. The Road Warriors, they are trying to blind him. They stuck that spike right in his eye. Rhodes is bleeding. But you can hear him screaming, Tony.
He is in a tremendous amount of pain. And you know, Jim Ross, the first thing I thought of when I saw this was that maybe this great career has come to an end. We got to get out of this. We'll be right back. against Joe Cruz in this event on World Championship Wrestling, and Rick's having a good time over here talking to David. Just walking around the circle out here. Finally made his way.
Well, as has been said, he may be a sandwich or two shy of a picnic, but that's, you know, he's got a great heart. Spends a lot of time at the toy stores. He's a pretty happy-go-lucky guy, at least he was. You know about his friend Alex, don't you? I guess David will be talking to both Alex and Rick Steiner. I understand Alex goes pretty much everywhere that Rick goes.
All right.
You know who Alex is, don't you, Tony?
No.
You'll see. I think the fans have it. You'll see who I'm talking about.
Well, one thing about it, Alex or no Alex, and Toy Store or no Toy Store, and Big Heart or no Big Heart, the man is a first-class athlete.
He's a stallion. That's what he is. He is a stud, no doubt about it. And, you know, there's so much to gain on December 26th at Starrcade. Steiner going for the World Television Championship. A first for him.
Well, you know, we had seen many times right here on Superstation TBS that he had defended the title. That contract is still on the table. And, of course,
the reason I'm saying that, Tony, is that Kevin Sullivan came out earlier in this program and said, if you want the match, you got it. So I'm assuming that they'll be able to negotiate that. We'll finalize that next week. I know they haven't signed the match.
If Kevin Sullivan says you can have it, we know Rick Steiner's going to want it.
Of course. I mean, you know, that's obvious. Steiner, just a little clinic there with Joe Cruz. Don't forget, fans, it's Monday night, the NWA in Macon. Tuesday night in Las Vegas. Wednesday in San Francisco.
That's downtown at the Civic Auditorium is where that is in San Francisco.
Also coming up Thursday night in Albuquerque, that's in the Tingley Coliseum. Amarillo Civic Center on Friday night, Sam Houston Coliseum 1 week from tonight back down in Houston. Well, Steiner's. Teddy Long just got his first victory.
Well, that's
here on World Championship Wrestling.
That is a first. And Rick Steiner counted him down.
Steiner, he is an awesome specimen. That guy is just phenomenal. Throws Joe Cruz right out into the crowd. We've got a great crowd here, too. Joe Cruz, fine young athlete, but Steiner is just on a different level.
Steiner, and here's a belly-to-belly suplex.
Belly-to-belly suplex, he is an animal. Rick Steiner, hopefully, will get the contract signed. I don't know if he's got an attorney. Maybe he'll sign the contract in the Crayola. Tony Schiavone's going to be talking to Rick Steiner here in just a moment at ringside, ladies and gentlemen. But we're going to take another look. Joe Cruz showed a lot of heart, but he's up against an awesome athlete. All-American from Michigan, there's a belly-to-belly suplex. Steiner plants Joe Cruz. Rick Steiner, of course, tonight in Greensboro, tomorrow night in Richmond, and right now at ringside.
Well, the blow-up we all expected has occurred, Rick Steiner, and now the issue is World Television Championship. The contract is on the table. Kevin Sullivan said it's yours if you want it, and you can go after that World Television title held by a man that you've said on many times that you can beat.
Mike Retardo couldn't fight his way out of a paper bag if there was a hole in it. A big hole.
Well, he's a fine champion, though.
Fine who?
Mike Rotunda.
Mr. Retardo.
He's held the title since January, and I think there's no doubt that you pose the greatest.
Yeah, look record. Who he had to wrestle, Dr. Death, and now they're buddies. Like, you know.
Never had to wrestle you, and in all your, let's talk about it.
I beat him before anyway. I beat Dr. Death, and I can beat Mr. Retardo, too.
Well, I think all the fans out there, and next week we're going to find out if that match comes to light. But you also have to realize there's Kevin Sullivan. There's Dr. Death on the outside. So if you go up against Mike Rotunda, it's going to be more than a one-on-one fight.
Alex is going to watch out for me.
This is Alex, right?
This is Alex. This is my new partner. See, I left Spike home today. Spike's in the bag. I brought Alex with me. Alex will keep an eye on things.
Okay, well, good for Alex. What exactly does Alex tell you?
He only talks to me, and I just listen to him.
So I can't hear Alex at all.
You can't hear Alex at all.
Well.
Want a kiss?
No. Okay, fans. Rick Steiner and the big match is on its way in Starrcade.
I can't wait. I'll beat him.
And you can beat Mike Rotundo, right?
Retardo.
Rotundo.
Retardo.
Whatever
you Retardo! Retardo! Retardo!
Whatever you say.
Thank you, Tony.
Okay, there it is from Rick Steiner. Certainly on his quest for the World Television Championship. More right after this timeout.
Ladies and gentlemen, David Crockett has gone to the hospital to check on the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. And David will not be with us the balance of the program. Here's Jim Cornette.
I heard what Paulie Dangerously said. Let me tell you something, Paulie. You don't never in your life have to worry about a kid running up to you saying, "Are you my daddy?" Because even if a woman would, you can't, brother. Ladies and gentlemen, I present Accept No Substitutes, not the original, not the extra crispy, but the real, beautiful Bobby and Sweet Stan, the Midnight Express.
We'll talk more about that. Maybe we'll get I don't think we can have a report this week, but next week for sure we'll have a medical report on Rose. David has gone to check on him now.
I got a report for you. It's about time people woke up around here. Look at here, Rip Morgan, he's drunk on Woolite in the ring. Season's beating December the 7th. Do you realize what that's going to hold? That is the first time that either one of the Midnight Express, Beautiful Bobby or Sweet Stan, have ever been in the ring against Ric Flair, the World Heavyweight Champion. The first time ever, Ric Flair and Barry Windham against Beautiful Bobby and Sweet Stan. It's going to be one of the classic matches of all time. I'm looking forward to it because we're going to finish the job that we started. Because of us, there's now two horsemen instead of four. Well, after that, there ain't going to be any horsemen, brother. And I want to say one thing to J.J. Dillon. It's going to be a classic match. So I'm going to sit outside that ring. I'm going to keep my tail wagging. I'm not going to interfere. But, brother, if J.J. Dillon don't keep those shoes on his feet and keep his nose out of that match, he's going to end up looking like Geraldo Rivera because we're going to have words. Now, as Midnight Express take this Max, whatever his name is, and beat the heck out of him, you know, Dennis Condrey and Randy Rose, they've been going around beating up these guys that they haul in here out of a soup line down here on Peachtree Street, and they've been calling them Bobby Eaton and Stan Lane. Now, it's a whole lot easier to beat up a couple of guys and call them Eaton and Lane than it is to do the thing to the real deal. But it did occur to me that maybe, just maybe, it'd be the same beating this little weasel up, this little wash rag, as it is that little toilet mouth Paulie Dangerously. So what I'm going to do right now, I am going to show you that I'm going to take this jacket that I've been carrying around with me, and I'm going to use it as a Johnny brush, and I'm going to clean that toilet mouth Paulie Dangerously's pipes out with it once and for all, brother. And at Starrcade 88, if we can't find him until then, the Midnight Express is going to do the same thing to Condrey and Rose. Hold on a second.
All right. Boy, he's on a roll here today.
He is his horse. He is taking that jacket.
Come on, you Yankee bum!
Well, I got too bad it's not made of chocolate because he certainly wants Dangerously to digest it. Polyester's not too edible.
Cornette has basically lost his voice out here.
You know what the problem is that punk right there doesn't have a big cavern mouth like Paulie Dangerously does, but I tell you what, Paulie wants to come out here and be a loudmouth. I wrote the book on being a loudmouth, and you know that as well as I do. Dennis Conner and Randy Rose want to come out here and be a tag team. Well, Bobby Eaton and Stan Lane wrote the book on being a tag team. And if they want to go into backgrounds, sure. I remember that Dennis Conner was a great wrestler when he joined the Midnight Express, when he joined Bobby Eaton and joined Jim Cornette. But he was a great wrestler, wrestling every Monday night in Memphis, Tennessee, in front of no people, no money. And that's where he'd be today if he hadn't joined up with us. Everything we did, everything we accomplished, we did it together, brother. But Dennis Condrey, he didn't have the guts to stand up, to straighten himself up, and to fight for what he had while he had it. And what he's mad about now is Sweet Stan Lane not only had the guts to take those shoes and fill them, but he had the guts to take those shoes where they'd never been before.
One,
All right, here I come.
What's your name?
That's certainly going to, that's not going to be very nice back in Huntsville, well, Alabama, his hometown. What? That's your microphone.
Yeah, I got a tooth mark right
there. We ain't playing no games around here. I don't care who thinks what about who the real Midnight Express is. We ain't playing no games. We have been dumped on, Tony Schiavone, if that's a polite way to put it, and we fixed a dump on some other people. Now they can copy the rocket launcher, they can copy the double goozle, they can copy any of our moves they want to copy, but brother, this one right here, the Sledge-O-Matic, by the time that the Midnight Express demonstrates this hold right here, it slices and it dices, and brother, Randy Rose and Dennis Condrey can copy anything they want to, but they can't copy that. We're sick of beating up dish rags. We want the real thing. We want Paulie, we want Condrey, and we want Rose.
And they will get them at Starrcade 88.
Well, they've come back out. You know, Jim, you brought up a good point about these two men just a minute ago.
I followed their career since they got in the wrestling profession. They put a lot of guys in the hospital, but never with a foreign object, gentlemen. I think we're a little
Jim Rush,
one step beyond.
What you want to do right now is hand that mic in our face and shut your stinking mouth, for I'd put your eye out with my stinking fingers. Hey, animal, what you got all over your hands?
I got the Dream's blood.
Ain't that the American dream come true? We didn't even feel like wiping it off or clean off. We just want to live in the gloriousness of it. You know, some people call their dog Spike. Football players spike the football. And people spike drinks. But some people, namely us, spike dreams. And that's what we're all about.
Well, I think
spiking dreams.
I think we need to take a look at the situation one more time. It's a horrible situation, but let's take a look. It happened earlier on this program.
Talk about the American dream. Here he comes. Hey, Dusty, he was out here just talking about
it. Let me tell you something about this old Texas boy right here. You've been coming out here week in and week out talking trash. Let's don't wait till Chattanooga, Tennessee, Daddy. Let's don't wait till December the 7th. If you want some of the dream, the legend, if you will, in public, come on out and get it right now.
All right, Dusty wants it. Dusty said, Animal, if you want him, get in the ring. Here comes Animal. Why'd you want him so bad? You want him? Go get him. All right, it's going to break down right here. They're not going to wait till December the 7th in Chattanooga. Big Road Warrior Animal, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. This is like a street fight here. He misses with a clothesline. Rhodes to the far side catches Animal with a clothesline. And he's trying to choke. Well, that's 2-on-1, Tony.
Well, you knew it would happen, Jim Ross. You knew good and well with all the Road Warriors here that it would be more. And all of a sudden, we see Animal. He is taking off one of the spikes. He is taking off a spike. And he has hit Dusty in the head with it.
He just hit Rose right in the face.
Oh, my goodness.
God, he's put it in his eye. He's put the spike in his eye.
He is jabbing him in the eye, or has, with the spike. He unhooked it from his shoulder pads or whatever it was, and he's jabbing into Dusty's eye. He's opened Dusty up.
Oh, my God. They're trying to put his eye out.
This is horrible.
They're sticking that spike right in his eye. The Road Warriors, they are trying to blind him. They stuck that spike right in his eye. Rhodes is bleeding. But you can hear him screaming, Tony.
He is in a tremendous amount of pain. And you know, Jim Ross, the first thing I thought of when I saw this was that maybe this great career has come to an end.
You know, Jim Ross, if anybody's got any doubt if this is real or it's not, take a look. That ain't plastic. Dusty Rhodes, your first mistake was even making a challenge to me. Now, maybe you had a chance with both your eyes, but you don't stand no chance at all with one eye. Don't you ever call yourself a legend. Come out here and take advantage of that, because I ain't gonna back down from no man. December 7th, I am gonna finish the job. You may have no eyes at all. Dusty Rhodes, I think it's time for you, like you said before, lay this body down, and maybe your time. We're gonna find out December 7th. You know, we come from the streets, and on the streets, you do anything to win. Dusty Rhodes,
I got a new name for you, Popeye. Popeye Rhodes.
Well, I'm sure you have something to add to this. You're happy, I'm supposed.
What we saw was Darwinism at its finest. Survival of the fittest. And Dusty Rhodes, what goes around comes around. Now we're going to have a charity for you, Dusty Rhodes. A charity for your eye. And all your fans can send the money to the Legion of Doom, and I'll make sure you get it.
Tony, I don't know what we can add to that.
Well, like we said, Dusty has been taken to the hospital. We don't know the seriousness of the injury. David has gone with him, an official of the NWA, and hopefully next week we'll be able to report on the situation on Dusty Rhodes.
We certainly will. And fans, we'll be back with more exciting action right after this.
Well, Paul, I'll tell you
what. Don't Paul me! You're probably involved in this conspiracy, too! If the assassins lose, they will unmask, and Paul Jones will have to retire. Well, let me get these ducks in a row. It started out with the cool loss that we were chasing them. And now it looks like we're chasing them until they catch us. Well, let me tell you something right now. This is a piece of paper. I'm going to get to the bottom of this. There is no way that the assassins will unmask. And there is no way the people will see their face. And as far as me retiring, I am too young to retire. I have a song to sing. When I stopped wrestling, I said I have something to offer the wrestling business. And I do. And Kolos, I know that I have enough pull around here to get to the bottom of this. And I will. And before it's over and the dust settles, Kolos, my men will not unmask, and I will not retire. You see, I have a special surprise. I am a lot smarter than you think. I always have an ace in the hole. And when the dust settles, you're going to see the assassins walk out of that ring, and you're going to see me back here on the next television show. And that's not only a promise, that's a threat to the Kolos.
All right. The assassins of Paul Jones, like he says, he's always has had an ace up the sleeve. Let's go back to the ring, fans.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the City of the Angels, please welcome Tommy Rogers and Bobby Fulton, the Fantastics.
Certainly want to remind the fans to join us tomorrow night at 7:30 in Richmond, and the NWA moves on then Monday night to Macon, Georgia, Tuesday night in Las Vegas, Nevada. The Showboat Sports Pavilion, first time ever for the NWA, the Showboat Tuesday night in Las Vegas.
That's going to be a big event, and I tell you now, we're getting closer to December 7th also, and the tournament for the U.S. Tag Team title, the championship match. And as it stands, the team that we saw at the very top of our two-hour program will face a team at the very end of our two-hour program. Fantastics against Eddie Gilbert and Ron Simmons.
I got to think that's going to be one of the fine scientific tag team matches that we'll have the privilege of seeing. Fantastics versus Ron Simmons and Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert. Cruel Connection 1 and 2, the opponents for Fulton and Rogers. And it'll be Bobby Fulton starting it out. I'll tell you something, we've talked about the NWA Wednesday night in San Francisco. We know that this Thursday night, Tingley Coliseum in Albuquerque, Friday night in Amarillo, but boy, I'll tell you, in Chattanooga, Tennessee, the UTC Arena, Tony, on Wednesday, December the 7th, it's gonna be, it may be something as explosive as what December 7th is known for, the attack on Pearl Harbor. Because this Rhodes animal situation, and we hope that Rhodes will be able to even wrestle.
That's a good question. Will he be able to wrestle? You know, the eye injury is serious business. And certainly, like we said, we're not so sure of the extent of the eye injury, but from the looks of it, it wasn't too good.
The gift of sight is such a precious one, and to try to snuff it out like the Road Warriors did, two men. I just, like I said, they've been so dominant, physically dominant, since they debuted in wrestling. And to have to use a foreign object, and both men, and And even Ellering was involved in this. It, you know, it's just really distasteful. And just
well, it's an effort. It's an effort because when they both attacked Dusty in the ring, Jim, they both had him. They were two men on one, two very powerful men, and basically there was nothing Dusty could do. So they didn't need to use that, certainly at that situation. Here's a backslide from Cruel Connection 1, but watch Tommy Rogers! And a great dropkick. No one does it better, like you said before, Jim Ross, and Tommy Rogers with a dropkick.
Arm bar there into the head scissors. Rogers and Fulton, I think they're going to match up very favorably with Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, but Ron Simmons may be a, I don't know, that may be a different story. You know, Simmons will no doubt be the biggest man in that match, and he is also going to be the strongest man in that match, I think we could say. Bobby Fulton is crawling around right on the edge of the ring here. He's right beside. And Fulton.
He got up right beside the other half of the Cruel Connection and was standing beside him for a second before he knew what happened and knocked him down.
You know, Eddie Gilbert's got a track record of being a little bit unpredictable at times. And so I think that's going to be most interesting. The stakes will be very high, but we have to think that going in is going to be a very scientific event. High-flying move by the Fantastics. And with Gilbert's ability to devise a game plan, Tony, I think we could both agree that he and Simmons will have a game plan that will win if the breaks present themselves against the tag team specialists, a team that going for the U.S. tag titles for the second time.
Almost had a pin on a great move right there. We see so many different moves from the Fantastics each and every week here on the Superstation.
You know, fans, I know everybody's been very busy here this post-Thanksgiving weekend, but whatever you do, there's a DDT by Bobby Fulton. Don't neglect to call your local cable company this week and inquire about Starrcade. Just remember, it's the day after Christmas. And that may be when Cruel Connection regains his senses a day or two after Christmas. And we just got a few moments here, gentlemen. I know you got a lot to say about December the 7th.
You know we do. You know I want to tell everybody out there that that's where we won the United States belts for the first time. Right there in Chattanooga, Tennessee. Eddie Gilbert and Ron Simmons, you guys are two tough customers. And I want you to remember that that's home for the Fantastics. And we plan on walking out with those United States belts again. Tommy, you want to talk about Dusty? I know. It was something else to see out here.
That's right. Bobby and myself have been in wrestling quite a long time now, and we've never seen something just as disgusting as what happened right here on TV today. And we just like to tell the Road Warriors one thing. With one eye or no eyes, Dusty Rhodes coming after you, brother.
That's
and
right.
I wouldn't want to be in your shoes.
And we'll see you next week on World Championship Wrestling.